You were watching the president last night there in the White House. Good news, right? He's going to destroy him.
Well, that's the good news. And the answer is we see a more determined president from the one that didn't have a policy, what was it, a week and a half ago, 2 weeks ago. On the other hand, it's not much of a policy. It doesn't commit enough troops, because troops are going to be necessary to get this job done. Doesn't acknowledge the fact that it's a war, which is really almost silly, because they're at war against us. I don't know why we struggle so much with whether we are at war with them. They are at war with us. So those things, I think, give it a kind of reluctance that's going to make it hard to put a coalition together.
Do you believe that this is a long-standing policy, one that will continue and sustain through polling, which may have been a motivating factor?
It doesn't sound like it. I mean, it didn't sound like this is a long-standing policy. Remember when President Bush addressed Congress after September 11? He said this is going to be a long, long time. I think he said, you know, not years, decades.
Yeah.
Well, he turns out to be absolutely right, doesn't he? He turns out to be absolutely correct. This is going to be decades, and it shouldn't surprise us. The Cold War was decades. So we need the commitment to remain in this with the forces that are necessary. I think, you know, having taken our forces out of Iraq is part of the reason that we have the situation that we have right now.
Right. Let's move on and talk about what today is. It means so much to so many people, so impactful for you. And the question is it going to happen again? You know, it happened in 93 and then it happens substantially in 2001 in the World Trade Center. Are we safer now than we were when George Bush left office than we were in 2001?
We're certainly safer than we were in 2001. A tremendous number of changes have taken place. We don't have to detail them all, but, you know, at airports, the amount of intelligence that's gathered and shared is much, much better. The New York City Police Department is about as well trained in counterterrorism as you can possibly train a police department. Ray Kelly started it. Bill Bratton, who did that in Los Angeles, by the way, is doing that in New York. So in those respects, we're safer. Now with this new threat, ISIS, some of the other things connected to it.
200 Americans involved minimum?
Yeah, if you ask me, are we safer than we were like 2-3 years ago, it sounds like probably why not. Now we're facing a new danger that we don't really understand completely.
Well,
we certainly are safer than we were, you know, the day before September 11, 2001.
Well, then why would we be less safe than we were 3-4 years ago? Is it because the administration took their foot off the gas?
I don't know that you really know exactly the answer to it. I mean, this ISIS thing seems to have been a surprise to them. It seems to have been a something they didn't really understand was going to emerge. So whenever you have a surprise and you don't have all the information, then how can you assess the full nature of
right.
the danger?
I worry about this mayor, combined with Bill Bratton, who's obviously very competent, but this mayor isn't. And when it comes to the threat, they're not flying over to these international events to study how it could affect New York like Ray Kelly was doing. So the combination of who's in the White House and who's running the New York City kind of worries me. But in the big picture, what are you doing today?
Well, today I'll be at the ceremony and be there to remember the friends that I lost and all the families that I've gotten to know. I get to see them. I get to see them again. And then I'm going to go to a Port Authority station. I'm going to go to a police station, and I'm going to go to a firehouse with the Secretary of Homeland Security. Really just to talk to them and remember. And then I get together tonight with a lot of the people that we shared the experience with. It was a day that was the worst day of my life, and it was the day that was the greatest day of my life. My wife and I have tremendous emotions. I mean, Judith and I have tremendous emotions about today. We remember almost every second of it, sometimes inaccurately.
Yeah.
You go back and remember it sometimes accurately.
Well, the key is to remember. All right.